Of course, the pastor was inspired to me by Jerzy when he wrote to me a while ago that he wanted the theme, general theme of that conference to be tech contra tech in a Wild West style. So I immediately think of the famous poster of Solidarność for the election on June 89. And since, of course, I prepared my slides at the last minute, I didn't have time to replace the date which shouldn't be 4th of June 1989. You can imagine it's about right today, 2nd of May 2008, and that he's not carrying a voting ballot, but probably the tech book or something like that.
I think it's the lowered E that he's trying to put into line of the tech logo.
Oh, yes, yes.
Who's going to draw past it?
So this was about, the idea of tech contra tech in general, of tech engines fighting against other tech engines. We have quite a lot today. So this, and tech engines, and of course, macro packages and all that. And so we did have quite a lot today. So the question that we raise here is, oh, not again. Why so many avatars of tech? Why so many? No. Okay. So by the way, I think I got that. I rebooted and all that. So why so many? And by the way, how many? Because we have different levels. We have engines. After that, we have macro packages. And still above that, we have distributions. And that distribute all of this. And finally, and Jonathan's talk was a good illustration, we have what I call source code editors. I mean, intelligent or pseudo-intelligent editors that would allow us to edit tech input. So we have to look at least at four different levels. And for each one of them, so let's start with engine. What do we have? We have, of course, traditional tech, really the one that produces PDF, DVI, that some people still use. We have Omega, because I wanted to speak about the engine, the different variants of tech that were still marginally alive today, and right after tech, you have Omega. You have all the different extensions like eTech were incorporated into PDF tech afterwards. So you have Omega. You have Aleph, of course, which comes with Omega. You have PDF tech, which is a bit, actually I think it came a bit earlier than Aleph, but later than Omega, but whatever. And then we had P-Tech, Code-Tech, the Korea, the Asian and Asian things. And of course we have Z-Tech and Lua-Tech. And then macro packages. We have plain tech, we have LaTeX, we have context, distributions. Well, it tends to get better now because we have mostly TechLive and MicTech. And Japanese users also have W32 tech, which is quite useful to them, mostly because of their P-Tech things and things like that. And then we also have all different sorts of distribution, which I'll call the package distributions. I mean, mostly for Linux, you have TechLive or sometimes T-Tech that comes in a package from the Linux distribution. So it depends. It often depends on the Linux distribution, what sort of distribution you will get. And you often don't have the choice. Sometimes you have a very obsolete T-Tech that comes with your Linux distribution. Of course, again, it's getting better. And where's Norbert? I mean, well, thanks to Norbert, it's getting better. Editors, well, we have, of course, quite a lot of them. WinEdit, I hear, is still quite popular on Windows, maybe. I don't know how old it is exactly, but I suppose it gets really old and people should better use other things, but I understand it's still used. We have Technic Center, something more recent for Windows. We have TechMaker on Windows, yet a third one. Then we have TechShop. Kyle is a small thing for Linux, I think, linked with KDE, or maybe not, but anyway, it's really for Linux. And then maybe we have TechWorks. I mean, not maybe, in some month of time from now. And then, of course, we also have all sorts of really general purpose editor. We have Emacs, VI, and whatever. So when we have that, it was really fun to do that in pseudo steps. If anyone knows some tech macro that would do that naturally, I would be really interested, because I had to just to do really, really ugly things to make it, to make the layout look like this. So anyway, we have all that. I like to think that actually tech, what we call tech, is not really this, but it's really all of this, because obviously anyone here, especially here, refers to tech as any combination of all of those things, because mostly we really need a combination of all that. So we have, for example, this has been typeset with Lua tech as an engine, context as a macro package, tech live as a distribution, and VI as an editor. And I think any of those things could be used. And more importantly, any of those things could represent what users think of tech. Jonathan noticed that for many people, tech who use Tech Shop, tech is Tech Shop. So they say it's Tech Shop. So very often it's difficult to know what the exact configuration of a user is, because nobody will ever mention those four levels, which are all essentials. At most, they mentioned two. I have problem with the LaTeX on Tech Live, so we try to solve the problem. But actually, the problem was introduced by TechMaker that re-encodes the source file behind your back. Or another user tried to help that first user that asked the question on some mailing list, and this one uses Technic Center, so he doesn't have the problem because the input wasn't re-encoded. I think this is really an important aspect of what tech is today. This machine is really starting to annoy me. And I want to quote something I heard this morning and which I wrote down. You get better tools for shooting yourself in the foot. So it's really, you get a lot of more tools, but the exact quotation was you get better tools, which is even better, I think, for them. So, actually, this was more or less the general idea of what I wanted to say about tech contra tech. But since I'm the prosecutor in that trial, or actually I'm the judge, but okay, we don't have many people. So now I will do the prosecutor and sum up all what we've heard from the witnesses today since this morning early. And this now comes to the second part of my talk, which is the case itself of tech contra tech. This morning I mentioned a few points, a few charges actually, as we say, against tech. And I would like to, as the prosecutor, I have to decide whether I find I find it guilty or not. So first point, I think this was my very first point this morning. We develop only for ourselves. Well, do we? Well, sure we do. I mean, anyone, Hans wrote context for his own need, and then he convinced Hartmut and Taco to start LuaTeX. And the development really started because Idris Hamid needed it. So we really develop each one for ourselves. Taco writes LuaTeX, Hans writes context, and Idris uses all those two layers to typeset his book about Arabic medieval philosophy, I think. So it's completely obvious. I think any of us just develop only for ourselves, and then only as a side effect for other people and for other users. And it's pretty much not important if we are willing to help those users, because we are helping them. We're helping them with tools that actually are meant for ourselves and not really for the users. So tech, I think, is guilty of being self-centered, you could say, just central to itself. My second point was, we're victims of tech. Well, are we or aren't we? I mean, who isn't? It seems quite obvious that anyone is victims of tech. I just mentioned I had many problems to build my funny list of tech engine and packages just 5 minutes ago. I think we're hardly actors. We're users of tech, of course, but we're also manipulated by tech, by the program itself. I mean, it's more centered on the program than on doing nice typography. Children are indoctrinated. We already mentioned that. I think it's hard to deny. Parents are also indoctrinated because it goes both ways. Also, as far as parents are concerned, they are often less flexible than the children, so it's really less easy when you want to convince your parent to change his badly encoded tech file from 25 years ago into something more reasonable, or to give up LaTeX 2.09. But I also had earlier this week. Oh, of course, it's not only about parents; it's only about professors. Also, if your old professor screwed up his UTF-8 encoding for writing a textbook in Slovenian, the tech is guilty. Guilty. We have too many different versions of tech. I think it needs no comment. We definitely have too many versions. Yes, of course, they're needed. They're the result of fundamentally different approaches. We need this for this and that. We need full control over the layout engine. We need to use nice fonts with advanced layout libraries. But the result is we have too many different versions of text. Even the name version is officially prohibited in the tech world because version of tech would mean a different version number of the tech program, which happens nowadays practically never. We just had a very new version of tech, I think, 2 or 3 months ago. But it's a further annoyance that there are some. It's becoming actually a religion. More on that point, I think, afterward. So tech is guilty of being too polymorphic, too multiform, or something. And by the way, they're incompatible, actually. They're not only incompatible with themselves, because obviously ZTech is not completely compatible with the Lua tech. You have to do many different things. Okay, if you use context, you can probably do the same thing with higher level macros. And they're also often compatible with themselves in the past. That is, you want to use PDF. What was the example by Martin? You use PDF tech, and all of a sudden, if you upgrade, you get more error messages. So you say, what's wrong with my input? No, nothing's wrong. It's PDF tech is wrong. It's exactly the same input, but now it gives an error messages for something that is no more an error than before. It just has changed status. Yeah, but you still get a warning. It's frightening. I mean, you shouldn't frighten users like this. The same with ZTech, which deal with complex script, where all of a sudden, when you upgrade ZTech to the latest SVN from, you have exactly the same thing. Something that was silently ignored becomes a harmful error or something. So tech is guilty of being incompatible with, generally incompatible with himself and with other version of himself. And next charge, tech forces us to understand what happens behind the scenes. Anyone who listened at David this morning about Bigfoot, I didn't, but anyone understand how difficult it is to really do something that is off the beaten track? Like if you are a dummy user, so to say, and you want to use LaTeX to do something special with a section number or the section title, you have to do completely unwrite a thing because the section number uses a very difficult definition which is deep down into the LaTeX core, and if you want to customize it, you only have like two or three options. You have only a certain limited choice to modify it, and for otherwise you have to rewrite all the definition of that macro. So it's it happened all the times. You really have to dig deep into tech and some. And it even goes to the point when you say, oh, I think there is a bug in that macro packages with, no, it's not a bug, it's a feature. You should change the configuration file to include this, and then you should recompile the format, and then you can modify that macro to give the result you would like, you would him to give. Only for a bit of more stretch or spacing or for changing the font style or something. So the my recommendation is to find him guilty of that charge. Next point. And it is therefore addictive. I mean, it happens to any of us when we have spent hours and hours of digging into the code to modify some remotely interesting option. We just can't do without it. I mean, it becomes really like a drug, like. I wish there someday there would be some rehabilitation center for tech, because we I think any one of us here has experienced it. We all need it.
And especially and that with tools such as TechShop or TechWorks, we are lowering the age barrier of that.
Yeah, I think we should really look into that. And it is therefore also our religion. I mean, people tend to have a really narrow-minded view on what tech should be, on what we should call tech, well, how we should use it. But fortunately, all other people are more widely open and want to lower the barrier and to entry. So it's proselytism. It's religious proselytism, like Christianism has been for 2 millennia. And my last question, I'm wondering, well, do we really use tech at all? Yes, unfortunately. I mean, we do really use tech. This has been typeset in tech. You have been looking at the output by tech during the whole day, and yesterday and the day before too. And that's bad. That's quite, I find him guilty of this charge too. So the verdict I request the prosecutor again is to find tech guilty on all charges, but we forgive him everything, and we appeal for clemency by the jury, and this is pretty much it. Pavel told me. Pavel asked Jonathan what the exact word was. So Jonathan said clemency. That's legal advice I'm providing, and so it means mercy in Kaiser. I had no problem with it because it's the same word in French, so it felt quite natural.
How do you pronounce it in French?
Clémence. And what this means for us, I mean, this for us as tech users and as tech mostly developers, of course, is another. I made a historical reference at the very beginning of my talk, and I have another one yet that I hesitated to put there, but I found, because I was afraid it was bad taste after citing Solidarność, but I thought why not use the old motto, tech users of all countries unite, which is what we've been doing for 30 years actually with the tech user groups and with different groups of different interests gathering here, and that's what Bachotech is about, I think. Not only, of course, tech development, but also beer and all that. And it's important for development. So this is my pleading, or whatever it's called. Even Jonathan didn't know the term. I'm not sure. I know the exact legal term in French too. And lest I forget, I always put my request on. Here, so I have a personal announcement. I would like to sleep somewhere in Warsaw Sunday evening. So if someone can give me shelter in Warsaw or Sulijovac or wherever, and not too far away, because I have a plane in the morning. Okay.
No comment.
club for a judge opinion. So.
No, actually, usually you have a lawyer after that, after a prosecutor.
Okay, let's make an example. Go ahead.
Yeah, and just doing a search on Google Groups for the keyword faith and religion. And I found that some flame war about faith as being an archaic religion was already going on in 1992. Years ago.
It's a good thing that you looked for tech and not LaTeX, because I am afraid if it looked at the string LaTeX, you would find other statements of religions about LaTeX or something. So.
I have to add that when I first developed Preview LaTeX and I first got the idea of Googling for the package, it was quite embarrassing. And probably was not the best choice of words. But by now, actually, most of the hits on the first 20 pages or so belong to me.
I think. You mean all previews belong to you?
All the links. I mean, there are no more pictures of me to be found.
Ah! So you.
Okay?
Personally, I would like to compare the situation described by Arthur, that is many text engines, many distributions. I would like to compare it to what happened for Lisp Dialect. At the beginning, there was only Lisp One Type by John McCarthy. And in the two decades after, there was many, many languages. Lisp, French Lisp, Zeta Lisp, and that was very rich because many, many experiments have been done. And in the first step, there was a big language, Common Lisp, that is an attempt to encompass all what. What defined in all the Lisp dialects, and this very simple Lisp as him. Maybe will be the same for tech. For example, some engines have disappeared. In fact, Cortex is not a tech engine. But before, the Koreans had H text for Hangul text. And context is a simplification of a text to be grouped into
a macro package. Wasn't attentive enough. Actually, my a comment about Lisp is that I never program in Lisp. I hardly know. I mean, I just know it's related to Lambda calculus. But my idea about it was always that it's quite frightening. And just now I realize that that's probably what many people think of tech before they're instructed, before they're educated in tech, so to say. I mean, I have no idea about Lisp. I know the name Common Lisp and Scheme, but it looks really frightening to me because I don't know what is incompatible. And interestingly enough, people are still... people are still programming in Lisp because Stasha can tell us about it. There is a new tool for indexing in the tech world called Zindi by Joachim Schrod. It's not that new, but I mean it was just upgraded. I mean it just got incorporated in a new version in TechLive, and it's written in Common Lisp, and it has been a major pain in the ass to find a correct Common Lisp compiler that doesn't request really weird and exotic libraries that would prevent non-developers to use the package. No, it was C Lisp. Maybe it was Scheme disguised in a C Lisp package on Debian, but I installed C Lisp to compile Zindi.
Common Lisp and Scheme belong to the same generation. That is, either a simple Lisp or an enormous one. They have been designed at the same time.
Okay. One of my ideas here was that there really should be a general document describing all that. For example, many people still use tech and not PDF tech, and there should be something that really describes what you get with PDF tech with the different macro packages, of course. Well, something funny and which may seem really innocuous is drawing watermarks with a draft copy package. And it uses a PostScript, a small PostScript code, it's very pretty. So it means that it doesn't work with PDF tech. I think, well, PDF tech must complain or something. So, I mean, really, it's a question that that comes very often on mailing lists, I find. And I think the general answer, the right answer to this, is to really explain to people you have tech, you have PDF tech, you have, of course, VTech and Lua tech, and the macro packages above it, and you cannot really do without it. Of course, that would be another argument for Michał Stok this morning, who said the short introduction to LaTeX is 150. It would be even longer, but I think there used to be some document, some description or something. So sometimes I even started writing this myself. I wrote long emails, a long explanation about what is tech and that. And each time it's a discussion I had last month. And each time the user, the person, asked a different question, showing that on a different aspect of that, of my big table, he still didn't understand anything. I had to explain about distribution, about tech engines, about macro packages, and in the end I just couldn't take it, I just dropped everything. But it's sad, because it's a part of tech development. And of course it should be, as you say, Jonathan, it should be TechWorks, only use PDF tech, but on the other hand, well, I don't know, it should really be, the entry level should be really low. But,
any other comments or objections or?
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Well, on the other hand, that I see that's one point by Chris Rowley in his comments. We it's not standard enough. We really need some standard, because I mean, people want to use macro packages. Okay, they want to do more or less fancy things in their articles, and sometimes they even need it. So we need a lot of macro packages. We have TechLive for that, which is really great, and MikTech has his installation on the fly of packages. So it worked really great, but I suppose publishing houses will want to have to put some limits on that, and I really see no solution from that. I mean, there should be one, but I get the impression that very few publishing houses are really ready and have the power and have the financial and human power to really say, use exactly these and these macro packages and their general style. I mean, even for Ulrich and other people at the bonfire 2 days before were complaining that even for the proceeding of that conference, it doesn't work. You cannot control the output of tech as much as you want. But you're right, of course. I mean, it's bad not to use tech. We should all use it. It's bad that they don't propose an alternative, at least.
Okay, thank you. I think you're done with it.